My name's Ron Kertge, K-O-E-R-T-G-E, an old German name. And if we were in Germany, it would be Kertge, but we're in the United States. The book that I'm talking about briefly is this book of revisited fairy tales, and the first book I ever had with illustrations. Usually, I just write a straightforward novel or a novel in verse. This is poetry or free verse, and enhanced really by the illustrations. I'll show you. This is from the Bluebird poem, the Bluebeard poem. They're wonderfully grisly and dark.
Yeah, I was saying, that doesn't look like a kid's book.
Well, frankly, we're not quite sure how to sell this book because I write for teens, obviously Candlewick, but it's a little dark for most teens. Probably offend a few librarians, upset some parents. So my career may be going into a spiral even as we speak.
Well, you can always think if it upsets the parents, then it's probably something the kids would love.
Well, you kind of hope that the kids pass it along. And I was talking to my publicists, and we're trying to figure out a way to, you know, cross-pollinate. Because adults should read this book. It's very funny, very snarky, you know, quickly written, terrific illustrations. So, do your best. I published with Little Brown when I was a young writer in my 40s. That kind of went south for various reasons. These things happen. I was without a publisher for a couple of years, and then by a circuitous route, somebody heard me read from a new manuscript and said, "Oh, I know an editor who's interested in things like this." I sent the manuscript there with some, you know, with a note saying I met so and so, and we've been together ever since, 20 years. I've got a history with my editor, Liz Bicknell, and what she does is a downshift on the advance, not pay me quite so much, because I think we're both realistic about this. This is going to be a hard sell. So, but she wants to keep me, you know, in the Candlewick stable, and I want to stay. So she doesn't want to drive me away to some other publisher. So it's one of those symbiotic relationships.